Antonina Shevchenko versus Ariane Lipski. We got minus 155 on Antonina and plus 130 on the Queen of Violence. And this fight has really pretty much stayed where the opener had it at roughly around minus 160 for Shevchenko. We did see a little bit of love for Ariane Lipski come in. However, it's all still Shevchenko, and a lot of people are in agreement in that. So let's start off with Ariane Lipski, who seemed to have reversed her unfortunate start to the UFC. You know, she comes into the UFC, loses a decision to Joanne Calloway. Then she goes out there and gets out grappled by Molly McCann. And then everybody's just going out there and willing to write off Ariane Lipski now. Then she goes out there, gets a super short notice fight against Isabel de Padua, who stepped in for, I believe, yeah, it was Veronica Macedo on weigh-in day. We saw de Padua. I think she was there to like corner somebody else. And luckily for her, she was able to come out with a fight, get a paycheck, even though it was a loss. But she still gets to walk home with a cool $8,000, $10,000, whatever it is. But we did see Lipski do a good job of, you know, pretty much, you know, going out there and get a solid decision victory over de Padua. Then she comes back as, I believe it was a pick'em. If I'm not mistaken, she was actually the dog here, minus 130 favorite. But I was surprised at the amount of love that was coming in on Luana Carolina. And I had to take a shot on Lipski at that point. And luckily it came through. And maybe not the way that I expected it to come through, but that knee bar that she was able to secure on Carolina was just beautiful. Not much happened in that fight in terms of being able to take or extract something from that and say, okay, this is what's going to happen in the Shevchenko fight. But, you know, it only lasts a minute and a half. She lands a beautiful body shot, which kind of like, well, it was kind of a counter because Luana was throwing a kick. Lipski throws a punch to the body. It gets Carolina off balance, drops her to the ground, and we see Lipski follow her to the ground. It seemed like Carolina was almost reversing the position. Then we see Lipski grab the knee and just absolutely torque it, get an immediate tap, and she gets a knee bar victory. Obviously, this is going to be much more, a much tougher out against Antonina Shevchenko. And this might be a fight that mainly stays on the feet. You know, I wouldn't be too, I'd be actually surprised if we saw Shevchenko go out there and try to just implement a grapple heavy game plan. You know, that was her demise in her last fight against Katlyn Chookagian, where we saw completely uncharacteristic Chookagian go out there and just absolutely just smother Shevchenko for three rounds. And she had a lot of close submission attempts, but we did see Shevchenko fight out of pretty much every single one of them, but still lose a decision victory where, you know, Shevchenko just seemed lost almost. Like Chookagian, as much flack as she gets, she is a bit of a higher level jiu-jitsu player compared to the rest of that division. So that was a solid performance on Chookagian's part. Before that, we did see Shevchenko pull off a submission victory over Lucy Pudilova in a transition that was absolutely beautiful, where she just took the back of Pudilova. It looked like Pudilova was going to be able to the reverse the position herself, but we saw Antonina just sneak her arm under her neck and then slowly start to squeeze, and we saw Pudilova just face force just go out, and it was probably one of the more you know, aesthetically pleasing submissions to see, just because of the veracity of it. It was a beautiful rear naked choke from Shevchenko. And then obviously before that, we saw her go out there and get out grappled by Amanda Ferry. Now, I don't think that Lipski will be capable of doing that type of game plan where she just goes out there, continuously takes Shevchenko down and just controlling her, because I do think Shevchenko's jiu-jitsu is decent. Like, it's good enough, and I think it's on par with Lipski's, actually. If this fight stays on the feet, though, that's where I'm really intrigued to see who gets the advantage. I do leave Shevchenko. I feel like she has the more polished striking. You know, Lipski, she's the queen of violence for a reason. She likes using her elbows. She likes using her Muay Thai. But when she's pressured and opponents are having success against her, we might see her start to falter, and that's where I think that Shevchenko will start to take over a little bit. You know, I was a fan of Lipski, but like against competition like this, where I feel like she'll be outgunned on the feet and she won't be able to have much success on the ground, I do lean Shevchenko, and I do understand why she's at the minus 150-ish favorite that she's at. I don't feel the most, you know, I don't feel so compelled to go out there and actually bet Shevchenko at minus 150. Now, if this line started to get closer, that might be a little bit more sexy and more appealing to me. But yeah, I do think Shevchenko wins this fight. But this fight should tell us a lot about Lipski for sure. Like, this is a legitimate test. Luana Carolina was not a test. Like, that was, like, I remember, I forgot who it was, but one of my Twitter friends goes out there and during fight week puts out a video of Luana Carolina doing like the worst types of push-ups that you could ever see. Like, her stick arms just barely getting her up. And, you know, I'm not saying, you know, if you do push-ups to completion and that you're able to actually, you know, complete a legitimate push-up that you should go out there and win your fights, or if you're not able to do a push-up that you're going to lose your fights. But like small things like that does kind of sway me a little bit in terms of just saying, okay, Lipsky should be able to beat a girl like this. And even on tape, I wasn't fully impressed with what I saw from Luana Carolina. So it played right into Lipsky's game. Not a lot of people thought that she'd pull off a knee bar in that, but it is what it is. She gets the victory a minute and a half into that fight. But I still like Shevchenko in this fight. I feel like she'll be cleaner on the feet. I feel like she will have a size advantage as well. So we got 5'8", 68-inch reach for Shevchenko, and 5'6", 67-inch reach for Lipsky. So slightly taller for Shevchenko. But I think, this is a solid spot for Shevchenko to get a victory, especially on the same night as her sister defending her title, and who should be, you know, who should win that fight pretty decisively as well. So I do like Shevchenko. Kind of lucky that we probably won't be hearing Valentina's just annoying, cheering every time that Shevchenko, or every time that Antonina lands a fucking shot. So that'll be nice to not have to hear, especially in an empty, you know, arena, or the Apex, I believe it's going to be at. So, I do like Shevchenko. I think she's cleaner on the feet. She might have the jiu-jitsu advantage as well, if I'm not mistaken. But I truly see this fight mainly playing out on the feet. And I think from distance, we'll see Shevchenko really start to pick apart Lipsky. But it could be a closer fight than the odds indicate. But I do think I know that I'm still edging Shevchenko here. So I'm taking Antonina to win this fight by decision. But it could be some shit. It could be some fireworks too that could potentially get this fight to go under. But I'll go the safer side. I'll say Shevchenko via, you know, outpointing for 15 minutes just winning a good fight. And she could, again, I do think that we could see Shevchenko start to initiate the grappling here, if the fight is kind of close, she could kind of close the distance. I think she'll be the stronger one too, so she might be able to get the better positions in the clinch and then potentially get this fight to the ground and see what she can do from there. But I think overall Antonina is the better fighter, and she is the one I'm going to be taking to win this fight via decision.